If you want to share a view in Airtable but allow your external users to edit the data in that shared view, look no further than this video, because that is exactly what I'm going to be breaking down for you, how to build that step by step. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where I make it my mission to help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools. We do this with automation and Airtable and just building automated processes and workflows in the background. If you're new here and you want to get started off on the right foot, I recommend checking out my webinar where I teach you the fundamental building blocks of no-code automation. If that's of interest, check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and that's going to give you the fundamentals so that you can start building in no-code and start reclaiming your time so that you're not wasting it doing these things that can otherwise be automated. But without further ado, let's hop into this video. We're talking about one of the most requested features from Airtable ever. And spoiler alert, Airtable actually released this feature a couple weeks ago, but they did so in error, and then they backpedaled on it and they took the feature away from us. And so for just a moment, we all got to know how cool it would be to have this feature actually natively in Airtable. But if they don't want to give it to us, that's okay. This is no code, so we can find a way around it. We can build a workaround, and that's what I'm going to be teaching you here in this video. Now, before we get into it, I do want to say that the inspiration for this video came from another channel that I've been keeping my eye on lately that's run by my friend Jamie over at No Code Ireland. If you're looking for more resources, more YouTube tutorials on Airtable, strongly recommend swinging by his channel and checking it out. You see right here on my screen that he, in fact, has a video that on this very topic that he pushed out a week ago. And while I haven't watched the actual video itself, I can understand where he's going with this, and so I'm going to be showing you my own perspective here in this video. But I want to be transparent about the fact that the original idea did come from Jamie, so thanks Jamie for the inspiration, and go check his channel out if you haven't already. Okay, so what are we doing? Well, let's first jump into our database structure, and we're going to talk about the three tables that we're going to use in this particular example. So flipping on in here, I have customers. Okay, I list out my different customers, and ultimately each one of my customers will have his or her own personal view. When they click on this view, they're not going to be added as users to my database. This particular view is going to help them see their orders, but only their orders. And what I want them to be able to do is edit those orders without being, again, users in my database. Okay, so how do we do that? Well, we have the orders table as well. Over here on my orders table, you'll see I only have orders right now on Gabe's shared view. So let's look at my all orders first. In my all orders, this particular view inside my orders table has no filtration. There is no filtering, there's no grouping yet. All I have here is I'm selecting an item, and I've got a few different options. Apple, banana, kiwi, watermelon. I've got a quantity, so any number can be keyed in here. Of course, then I'm linking to a customer as well. And then there's a bunch of magic for the back end. In terms of what I'm tracking, I want to specifically look at when was this record created. So that's my date time created. If you're not familiar, you can use a created time field here. And then I also have a last time modified. So I want to see when was the last change made to this record. And this is only watching specific fields, folks. It's only watching item and quantity. So again, any change made to one of those two fields is going to be reflected in the timestamp here. So this is going to always reflect the most recent time that an edit was made. Also, I'm calling up the record ID. This is an important step as well. If you haven't used record IDs before, you got to get comfortable with them. This ID is unique to every single record that is created in Airtable, and we like using this ID because it makes sure that we never accidentally do the wrong thing. The ID is unique, and so every time we use it, we know we're using the right record. So I'm going to call that with just the record ID formula here, no hard thing there. And then my last piece is my edit record formula. And this is where the magic is going to happen. This is where I'm including some sort of form, and I'll show you how we build this. And then I'm pre-filling that form with all the information that currently exists for this particular record. So in this case, I'm pre-filling the item with the item. I'm pre-filling the quantity with the quantity. But most importantly, I'm pre-filling the original record ID field, which I'll show you in a moment. I'm populating that with the actual record ID of this particular record. Whatever record clicks on this button is going to be unique, right? The item, the quantity, and the record ID are all unique, and so we want to make sure that we're passing those through. But what I don't want is for my user to be able to adjust that record ID. That's the secret sauce that's going to make this thing work on the back end. So I then, as my final step, have to hide that record ID. So then I say, and hide underscore, whatever the field name is, equals true. So I will post this formula below in the comments so that you can start to replicate your own version of it. But these are the basic building blocks, and I've done numerous videos showing you how to pre-fill forms, how to hide fields in forms. So if you have any questions, of course, you can check those videos out as well. All right, moving on. Where's this form actually built? Well, this form lives in my third table, and I've intentionally included an emoji here that shows the gear icon because I want to demonstrate that this particular table is just for the background operation of the database. I will never actually go to this table. In fact, when it is done, I can just delete all of these records after they've already performed their function. So what is that function? Well, I have a form, and this form is collecting those elements that you just saw, the item, the quantity, and the original record ID, right? Of course, as you know, I'm pre-filling all of this information, but as it's pre-filled, the user can then make a change to it and then submit. And of course, we are hiding that original record ID. So, going back to our grid view, these are the three elements that we're capturing, the item and the quantity and the record ID. I should point out that this record ID is text. This record ID is where we're pasting in the record ID that we've passed along from the other table. Don't make the mistake of actually using the record ID formula here. This is just text. All right. Now, we build an easy automation, simple two-step automation that says every time a form is submitted, that edit a record form. So when this form is submitted, that's going to trigger the automation. And what we want the automation to do? Well, we want it to update a record. So in the second step of our automation, we say update. In the orders table, update the record that matches the original record ID that we passed through in our form. And I want you to update these parts. I want you to update the name, and I want to update the quantity based on the new submission of the form. Pretty straightforward, pretty simple. That's it. Those are the only pieces that we're allowing folks to update on that form. So let's see how this thing works in action. I can close down my automation, of course, make sure it's turned on. And what winds up happening is we provide each one of our customers with their own unique personal view. So we do that in our orders table. As you see, I've already built one for Gabe here. And all we do here is apply a filter for Gabe. Then I make sure to hide the superfluous fields. So over here, he doesn't need to know what his record ID is. Obviously, he knows who he is as a customer, so I can hide those fields. But I do want him to see the item and the quantity, most importantly. And I want him to be able to also see when was this item created and when was it last modified. And most importantly, bring in that edit record button. In that button, again, we have our somewhat complicated formula where we're stringing along all the different pieces that we need for that particular record to be edited. Again, we're doing that with the form that we produced on our third table. All right, so let's take this out for a spin. Gabe then is presented with this link. He can open this link, so can we, and we see what anyone else would see when you are not a user in Airtable, and instead you're looking at a shared view. I can't edit any of this information directly here, but what I can do now is push this button, which we know is going to open up a form. This particular form, because I pushed the button for 3 bananas, is opening up, and it's already pre-filled with that information. If he wants to make a change here, he can, either to the item or to the quantity. Maybe that was supposed to be 30 bananas. Okay, submit. What happens? Go back to that shared view. Of course, he has to refresh his page. And when he does so, we're going to see that update right here. 30 is the quantity. And so we know on the back end, all of the magic is happening, right? Back in our particular automation, that new submission was received for 30 bananas, not 3. The automation knows what that record ID is, it goes into the order table, and it updates that particular element, that record, appropriately. And it's that simple. It took less than 15 minutes to set all this up. The only hassle of this is that you have to now create this particular URL, this particular shared view for each one of your customers. So this is definitely why I prefer to use third-party tools if I'm building an actual portal. That way I have actual edit capabilities. So things like Softr will allow you to build a user interface for your users that is far more superior to what we've done here. But hey, if you're on a shoestring budget or if you just need some simple functionality, this should get you there. So the missing piece here, of course, is that we need to recreate this particular view for each one of our other customers. So in this case, I've got Darcy Kemper here. Well, I can create a view specific for him simply by taking Gabe's shared view, duplicating it, renaming it, of course, to Kemper. Go ahead and paste him in there and remove the word copy. And then, of course, I have to change the customer to reflect Darcy as well. Now, Kemper doesn't have any records in our database, so it's a blank view. Now, the last piece is we have to make sure to share this view, create that shareable grid view link, copy that URL, and go ahead and bring it back to our customer table so that we can keep track of all the different views that we've shared with our customers. That's it for this video, folks. I hope you got a ton of value out of it. If you did and you want to learn more, be sure to subscribe to this channel because we put out constant videos about no code and automation. In the meantime, leave any comments you have below, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.